Where do you get your answers? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. So, unlike search engines like Google or Bing or others, AskLeo is a real person. Me, Leo Notenboom. That means when I get a question, and I get so many questions, I take various steps to come up with the answers that I post here or that I just respond with. I get a lot of questions. Unfortunately, that means I can't answer every single one. However, I do want to outline some of the resources I use when I need them. Now, here's something that I am completely open about, but people rarely realize. I don't know everything. I don't. And anything I may have known, I stand a pretty good chance of already having forgotten. Fortunately, knowing everything isn't what makes or breaks a service like AskLeo. What's more important is knowing how to find the best answer. How I find answers fall into one of two buckets: experimentation, search, or some combination of the two. It's almost a frustration. Lots of questions that I get can be answered by experimenting, just trying whatever the question is about. For example, what are these three dots over here? I don't know. Why don't you click on them and find out? Seriously, why don't you click on them to find out? For a surprisingly large percentage of the questions I get, I do exactly that or its equivalent and report back the answer. The reason I point this out is that you don't need me to fiddle around for you. You can click the three dots yourself. You can try things and save yourself a lot of time. If you're scared of breaking something, well, I've got two answers for that. One, you will not break your computer. It's much more resilient than that. Yep, you might confuse it, but 99% of the time, you can quickly undo whatever it is you did and be on your way. Seriously. And seriously, you will not break your computer's hardware unless there's a screwdriver or a hammer involved somehow. The second, of course, is probably what you'd expect me to say. Restoring a backup is the ultimate undo. Let's say you do something that really does turn out to be so incredibly confusing to your computer that it no longer even boots. Honestly, I cannot think of anything that you could do that would do it that easily, but let's just say there is. Fine. Restore your most recent image backup. And it's as if whatever it is you tried never happened. Except, of course, that you now know, don't do that again. My sense is that many people are much more afraid of their computers than they need to be. It won't break easily, and if it does, you can fix it. Now, of course, at the other end of the spectrum, search engines are your friend. If you're willing to spend a little time learning how to use them well, Google and other search engines can be your best friends. What do I mean by learning? Anyone can throw some words at Google and press search, but there are several aspects to Google that most people overlook. Knowing which words to search for to get relevant results, knowing how to interpret those results effectively, knowing how to use Google's advanced search, extended syntax, and additional features. By becoming proficient at using search engines and other web-based tools, you can frequently get the answers you need very quickly on your own. If I don't know the answer, and even sometimes when I do, I turn to search. Google, actually these days I've been using Kaji, it's my best friend, for this stuff anyway. AI is your new friend. AI gets things wrong. I'll get that out of the way. We know that. But that means we know to look for that. But AI is much better at figuring out the intent of your question than a traditional search engine might be. As a result, it does a better job of understanding what you meant as opposed to what you said or how you said it. You'll still need to double-check the results, but you'll likely have some well-targeted answers to begin with. Sometimes, pasting in an error code or an error message into an AI like perplexity.ai can be enough to send you towards the solution you're looking for. When I'm running low on ideas or I just I know there's a solution, I just can't think of it. I often will use AI to supplement my standard searches. And definitely, keep an eye on this space. AI is getting better and better at this stuff. Make more friends. You may find that depending on your searches, search engines send you to some sites repeatedly. If it turns out to be a common source of good information, then sometimes it's easier to go straight to that site and use the search functions there. If you already know some basics about what you're searching for, you can get answers more quickly by focusing on specific resources. Microsoft and Microsoft support, for example. Information isn't always the easiest to find there, or perhaps understand, but there's a ton of information and answers in the Microsoft Support Knowledge Base and peer-to-peer discussion forums. Your computer manufacturer. For problems with your specific computer, honestly, there are few resources as authoritative as those provided by the manufacturer. Yes, the quality varies, but I send people to these resources often. Same vein, your software manufacturer. I'm surprised again at how often people don't do this. If I have a problem with software X from company Y, the first thing I do is search for company Y's website and to see what support they offer. There's rarely anything more authoritative than going to the source. Sometimes the search options offered by the various websites we encounter are less than ideal. Not to worry. There are techniques you can use to search even the specific resources I've mentioned using general purpose tools like Google and other search engines. Sometimes, though not always, the general purpose tools are more effective than the search provided by the sites themselves. For example, using Google to search for site colon askleo.com space Windows space 10. That causes Google to return results only from askleo.com. Sometimes searching microsoft.com using Google will return different results than the Microsoft website's own native Bing-powered search. Regardless of what information I find and where I find it, my experience and expertise helps me weed out the garbage from the accurate and useful information. That is indeed some of the value that I try to add. But even without having made your career in computers, you too can use the resources I've talked about to get more answers and solve more problems, all without waiting for me or someone like me to get back to you. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2192. If you've got a question, askleo.com/ask is the place to go. If you're interested in my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, askleo.com/newsletter. And if you're willing to maybe help keep this circus running a little longer, askleo.com/patron has some options for you. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.